Let's imagine you have just built a promising app that the world has never seen before. New users are coming in, but can your database scale to handle all the incoming requests? Amazon DynamoDB is built to handle internet scale application as traditional databases cannot handle millions of requests per second during Black Fridays or Cyber Mondays kind of scenarios. You can store hundreds of terabytes of data in DynamoDB and can expect great performance. So let's discuss key features of DynamoDB. DynamoDB is a fully managed, multi-region, multi-master, and highly available database. And all your data is replicated across three availability zones, and you don't have to worry about patching and upgrading. It's a NoSQL database. That means it's not relational database. Amazon DynamoDB is primarily designed to manage semi-structured data. DynamoDB tables do not have a fixed schema. They are schemaless, so each data item can have a different number of attributes, which is very different to a relational database, which does require the attributes in a table to be consistent. It will scale through massive workload and will be distributed, and that's what makes it scale. You can issue on it millions of requests per second. The really good thing about DynamoDB is that you get fast and consistent performance. So that means every retrieval will be low latency, usually in the single digit millisecond. It will be integrated with IAM for security and authorization, which is the best practice in AWS to manage security anyway. On top of it, we can enable event-driven programming for your DynamoDB streams, where we can reply to events that happen to our table and see in real time that what we want to do about it. It's a low cost and has auto-scaling capabilities, which makes it the perfect serverless database. Now, let's log into AWS console and see how DynamoDB dashboard looks like. So basically, DynamoDB is a database, but you don't need to create databases as they are already there for you. It's made up of tables. So let's create a new table here. Let's name it players. Each table will have a primary key, and you can also define a composite key by including a sort key. So let's define player ID as the primary key and country as a sort key. Each table can have infinite number of rows, and each row may have different number of attributes, which we don't need to define at the table creation, which is in contrast to any RDBMS. The maximum size of a row can be up to 400 kilobytes. However, you can have any number of rows of this magnitude. So this is really important decision while designing for your storage that what kind of data it holds. As DynamoDB has a limitation of 400 KB, while S3 can store objects up to 5 terabytes in size. So here, either we can simply create table with default settings or can provide customized configurations. And key thing to define here is the throughput you need in terms of read and write capacity units. Read capacity unit or RCU is the number of elements you will read per second, while write capacity unit or WCU is number of elements you will write per second. And you have a capacity calculator here where you can calculate the required read and write capacity. So if your item size is 1 KB and you want to read and write one item per second, you will need 1 read and write capacity units. However, if your item size is, let's say, 300 KB and you want to read and write 1 item per second, then you will need 38 read capacity units and 300 write capacity units. And worth noticing here that it will also increase the cost. You can also turn on scaling and impose encryption on your DynamoDB data. So let's go ahead and create this table with default settings. And now let's try to add some data in this table. So as we can see here, this table is being created. Let's try to refresh this table. So we can see it is available. And this is where we can create records into this table. So let's say player ID is P01 and it represents country USA. Create this row. Let's try to add another row here with player ID P02 representing country as India. And here we also want to add another attribute as city, that this player is from Delhi city in India. So here we can see that we have two rows and both the rows has different number of attributes. So you can have any number of rows in your DynamoDB table with varied number of attributes. Now you might be thinking that how DynamoDB relate in data engineering? Well, there are some very common use cases that includes mobile apps, gaming, digital ad service, live voting, audience interaction for live events, sensor network, log ingestion, access control for web-based content, metadata storage for Amazon S3 objects, e-com, web session management, etc. In terms of anti-patterns where DynamoDB is not a good choice for example, RDS like fixed schema, complex joins or complex transactions or large size objects. This is a very common pattern, and in general, if you have large data that has low I/O rate, so few write or very few read, then S3 is going to be a much better storage option for you. So the use cases are quite diverse, but basically that means that anytime if you have some data that need to be very hot, small in size, and needs to be ingested at scale within a database, then DynamoDB is going to be a great fit for that.